Well, good morning and welcome. I'm John Levy. It's my privilege to serve as the 10th chair of the board of the Legal Services Corporation. Thank you for joining us this morning for these significant panel discussions. I do want to again thank Squire. It's hard for me not to put the Sanders in there. Pat and Boggs for hosting a terrific reception last night, and what a view, and what a turnout. I also want to thank Cleveland's Public Library for hosting this event and for partnering with LSC and the Legal Aid Society of Cleveland to help expand access to justice. That partnership will be the focus of one of our panels this morning and will be moderated by LSC's very own distinguished, longest-serving president, Jim Sandman. Preceding that panel will be a discussion on the importance of access to justice to the judiciary, featuring four state Supreme Court justices from around the region. LSC's remarkable vice chair, Harvard Law Professor Martha Minow, just recently ending her 8-year tenure, I'm sure she is relieved, as dean of that school, will moderate. The final panel will discuss access to justice issues from the perspective of the business community and features corporate executives from four leading companies. That panel will be moderated by LSC's Vice President for Legal Affairs and General Counsel Corporate Secretary Ron Flagg. We will also be privileged in a moment to hear remarks from the President of the Board of Directors of the Legal Aid Society of Cleveland, Vanetta Jamison. Following this morning's panels, ABA's President, Linda Klein, who is with us, and Legal Aid of Cleveland's outstanding Executive Director, Colleen Cotter, will join Jim Sandman and LSC's Director of Data Governance and Analysis, Carlos Langeres, to discuss the 2017 LSC Justice Gap Report, a report that we just released in Washington a few weeks ago. This is an important study, and we hope it will be useful in shaping the national discussion regarding the accessibility of our justice system. I'll leave the details of the study for the lunch discussion. But the bottom line, well, probably we didn't need a report to tell what I think you all know, what we know. Way too many people are being left out. Way too many of the nation's most vulnerable citizens are being denied access to justice. I know, ladies and gentlemen, I'm speaking largely to a choir, but this is happening on our watch and in our time. The crisis in access to justice is real. We can wring our hands about it, or we can get down to business. LSC was founded with the recognition that equal access to justice is not only a core American value, it is essential to maintaining our democracy and the rule of law. And to do something about it, we have to ask ourselves some hard questions. Why does our society take our justice system so lightly? Why has the third co-equal branch of government never really been co-equal in recent years in terms of staffing and money? Why is it so difficult for us to devote the resources necessary to make our justice system, to make sure that our justice system is what we say it is? And we all know something else. Investing in the justice system won't cost nearly as much as so many other national programs that we all know about. I think much of this must be a lack of education and information. As Texas Chief Justice Nathan Hecht observed a few years ago at LSC's 40th anniversary conference, quote, "We hope that justice has few enemies. Most of what we struggle with, I don't think, is opposition to justice, but ignorance of what is going on," unquote. So throughout our tenure, this LSC board, apparently, we don't have money for the lights, has tried, we've tried to address this ignorance. We formally kicked off a national dialogue about this crisis with a forum that we co-hosted at the White House in April of 2012. Well, you know, we've held similar forums like this one at every LSC board meeting since around the country. We've returned every year to Washington to try to draw attention, to call attention to this crisis. Well, these events have brought together leaders from business, government, philanthropy, as well as the greater legal community. The board further widened the scope of this dialogue with the creation of the LSC Leaders Council last year. This growing group of leaders comes from the fields of law, business, academia, sports, other disciplines, and its mission, simple: raise awareness of LSC and its grantees' essential work. Former Bush White House counsel Harriet Myers, Merck CEO Ken Frazier have been remarkable co-chairs. They're doing a lot more than they ever expected they would have to do, but they've rolled up their sleeves. And the Leaders' Council includes former Attorneys General Eric Holder, Dick Thornburgh, who just wrote a wonderful op-ed. I don't know if you saw it, but if you didn't, go look it up. Viacom Vice Chair Sherry Redstone, Microsoft Corporation President Brad Smith, Carlyle Group CEO David Rubenstein, former Major League Baseball player, I think I don't even have to say that, Hank Aaron, Bud Selig, John Grisham, and I think you all have a great love and affection for the University of Michigan's head football coach, Jim Harbaugh, to name just a few. Now look, if you have that much affection for him, get Urban Meyer to join us. Council members have been active in the effort to raise public awareness of the civil legal aid crisis. Just a few weeks ago in Washington, Frazier, Myers, and Harbaugh spoke at our event, releasing the Justice Gap Study. And I have to say, Jim Harbaugh came up with his own analogy, and it's a powerful one. What if I only gave 20% of my team that can afford helmets, and protection? And I just said to the rest of you, just go out there and we don't have anything for you. Try and play the game. What kind of team would I have? What would that say to the teammates about one another? Well, the Leaders Council is helping to show the way, but it's a path that everyone in this room can and must follow. We lawyers understand that funding is woefully inadequate to provide equal access to justice. We understand that our courts are packed, clogged with pro se litigants. We, and this is particularly significant, understand that the fundamental importance of equal access to justice to our way of life has somehow slipped from public view. But if civic leaders and our fellow countrymen don't appreciate this core value, how can we ever expect adequate funding for civil legal aid? And if we lawyers, officers of the court, do not speak up, well, who will? So I hope that as lawyers, you will embrace, as I know you do, your special responsibility, that you'll use your voice to speak up when the justice system needs you, as it does now. For as Bobby Kennedy so eloquently observed 50 years ago, each time a man stands up for an ideal or acts to improve the lot of others or strikes out against injustice, he sends forth a tiny ripple of hope, and those ripples build a current which can sweep down the mightiest walls. Let's get to work. Thank you very much. It's now my great pleasure to introduce Vanetta Jamison, President of the Board of Directors of the Legal Aid Society of Cleveland. Vanetta joined the Legal Aid Society's board in 2011 and became its president in 2016. She's serving her second term as president as a client-eligible board member. Vanetta's been an entrepreneur, active member of her community for a decade, prior to joining Legal Aid. Her connection was solidified through the encouragement of her attorney at Legal Aid, Susan Stauffer, who describes Jamison as a fabulously determined woman, so dedicated to her kids, and I know she's so dedicated to Legal Aid. Vanetta now works at the Department of Veterans Affairs, and I guess she's going to help me turn the lights back on. Vanetta.
Good morning. Thank you. To Chairman John Levy, President Jim Sandman, and the Legal Services Corporation Board of Directors, welcome to Cleveland. Cleveland is the home of the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame, the 2016 NBA Champions. It's the second largest performing, has the second largest performing arts venue in the United States, known as the Cleveland's Playhouse Square. It's also the home of the late and great Jesse Owens. It's the birthplace of Superman, which you already know and heard several times yesterday. And last but not least, it has been the home for over 111 years to one of the greatest service organizations in the United States and probably the world, the Legal Aid Society of Cleveland. It is an honor and a privilege to bring you greetings and welcome from the Board of Directors. Our board of engaged volunteers consists of 14 attorneys, one non-attorney professional, and 8 community representatives, which I am one of, all of whom bring a wealth of knowledge and experience from their professions and the 5 counties they represent and we serve. The level of dedication and commitment that the board has is enhanced by the talented, professional, and highly qualified Executive Director Colleen Cotter, 40 staff attorneys, and 25 additional support staff that continue to serve the greater Cleveland area. In our service, we are focused on safety, education, economic security, shelter, and ensuring justice systems are accountable and accessible. With the collaboration of our staff and some lights, and 2,800 pro bono attorneys, in 2016, we were able to serve over 18,000 individuals, 70% of those being women. Allow me just a few moments to share with you a story regarding a client of the Legal Aid Society of Cleveland. Many years ago, 2 young ladies graduated from high school together. They were best of friends. However, one went on to college and the other got married and had a baby. The freshman year of the young lady that went to college, she received a letter from the young lady that had gotten married. The letter went something like this. "Hey girl, hope you're enjoying college. I really miss you, but I really want to let you know marriage isn't all that I thought it would be. My husband is abusing me. He's financially, mentally, physically, and emotionally abusive. Not only am I afraid for myself, but I'm afraid for the life of my young child." The young lady that had gone to college immediately contacted her friend, and they talked about options, and they came to the conclusion that she needed to get a divorce fast. With no money and no family support, the young lady that went to college said she had heard about this place somewhere downtown. It's called the Legal Aid Society. Why don't you contact them? That young mother, she contacted Legal Aid, and she was able to get an expeditious divorce. And to this day, credits Legal Aid Society of Cleveland for not only giving her an expeditious divorce, but saving the life of herself and her young child. You would think the story would end there. No. Let's fast forward about 20 years. The young lady that had gone to college, she never finished school. She was now a wife and a mother of 5 children. But unfortunately, she was facing a divorce as well. Overwhelmed, confused, devastated, and financially challenged, She contacted her friend, and they discussed the options. Her friend said, "You gave me great advice about 20 years ago. How about you take a little bit of the advice on your own?" And she did. She contacted the Legal Aid Society of Cleveland, was given a great attorney who assisted her through a divorce. She recalls one time in the halls of justice in the Great Cleveland area, sitting and attempting to study statistics because the divorce wasn't difficult enough. She decided to go back to school and get her degree at the same time. She watched the attorneys go in and out, watching the talking to the magistrate, coming back out and talking to her, and her soon-to-be ex-husband, asking many questions and confusing her even more. The attorney at one point came out and asked a question, and the young lady slammed her books closed that she was studying. With big tears in her eyes, she looked at her attorney and said, "I can't do this." Her attorney stood still and said, "What can't you do?" Young lady, overwhelmed, said, "I can't do the divorce and get my degree." The attorney, the legal aid attorney, stood firmly in front of her with her hands on her hips, because that's what Legal Aid Society of Cleveland attorneys do. And she looked at that young lady and she said, "You're not doing the divorce. I am. You get your degree." That young lady remembers that moment often, and she was continued to be encouraged throughout her divorce. She thought one day, "I'm going to give back to that organization that not only assisted me in my divorce, but empowered me to move forward." 7 years later, that's exactly what I did. I am grateful to be a member of the board of directors, the governed over the organization that not only provided quality legal service to me, but more importantly, cared enough to reach down and pull me up. Because of the dedication, hard work, commitment, perseverance, and compassion that the Legal Services Corporation and the legal aid societies across the country, including the Legal Aid Society of Cleveland, give, we have the power to empower our clients that we serve to live beyond the current moment of despair. So again, on behalf of the Board of Directors of the Legal Aid Society of Cleveland, I thank you for your dedication and investing in people, and welcome to our home.